Before we get into the video, I just want to disclaim this video is solely about reaching Pirate Legend as quick as possible. I do acknowledge that in some ways it's definitely about the experience and not the goal, but this video is fully about reaching Pirate Legend in the quickest time possible, and I do not encourage anyone to do this. I'm just telling you how it's done and what I did to get Pirate Legend in under 24 hours. Thank you. So over the Golden Glory weekend of January of 2021, myself and the Marauders with the guide of Disabled Chicken took on the challenge to become the world's fastest unofficial Pirate Legends. We successfully accomplished level 50 in all three of the original factions within 7 hours. Now granted, doing this in 7 hours was aided by the Golden Glory event and a server alliance, but I can guarantee that if you do take these methods, you can get this done with under 24 hours by yourself. For proof of that, what you can do is head on over to Disabled Chicken's YouTube channel. It'll be linked down in the description. Have a look at his Pirate Legend under 24 hours. That was done and heavily inspired the run that we did over the weekend. So with that out of the way, I'm going to break this down into three different parts, starting with Merchant, moving to Order of Souls, and then finishing with Gold Hoarder. All of these have different methods that you can do to get the fastest completion, so buckle up, sit down, and take some notes. Let's get into it. So first of all, we're going to be focusing on the main three factions, as I mentioned just previously. You can do these in any order. I'm just going to tell you the order that we did them in for the sake of convenience. So starting off, we have the Merchant Alliance. Now, the reason we chose Merchant Alliance to start with is because it's definitely the easiest and the quickest, but as a result of that, it is definitely the most boring because you'll be spending 95% of your time sailing from island to island and doing a whole lot of not much interesting. So first of all, you need to make your way to the Devil's Roar, as that is where you'll be spending your entire time on this whole session. The fastest way to achieve levels in the Merchant Alliance is done through cargo runs in the Devil's Roar. Now, if you've never done a cargo run, all it essentially means is you need to pick up some cargo and take it to another place. Since it is in the Devil's Roar, items are worth more and give you more reputation, and the whole area is much, much smaller than what it would be, assuming you're in the Overworld. Overworld being the main part of the game that is in the Devil's Roar. Now, Ashen cargo runs aren't the only way to reach max level. First of all, you have to reach level 15, which can be done pretty quickly within a couple Devil's Roar runs. And then once you have maintained level 15, get yourself an Emissary flag, and you'll keep that up for the entire session. From that point on, it's very simple. You just need to hold on to your grade 5 flag and keep rerolling Devil's Roar missions. There's really no strategy to it. That's why it's the simplest and the quickest, but it is extremely boring in my experience. You can get this done in about 4 to 5 hours now. Of course, that will vary on how big your crew is, how efficient you are. For me, it took around 2.5 hours with the aid of the Winterbound and Naptime Hero, two friends of mine also on my Twitch team. But of course, you'll find yourself doing this within around 2 to 5 hours. Could be a little bit longer. Maybe shorter if you are lucky. That's a ballpark figure. While doing that, it is a good idea to passively pick up things like gems, skulls, chests, and other sorts of things to make your way to the next level. After reaching level 49 in the Merchant Alliance, what you can do is get yourself one level reputation purchase and buy your way to level 50, since you can only have one. It's most efficient using it right at the end to finish that off. From that point on, you can call it a day on Merchant and move on to one of the other two factions. For the sake of convenience, we went on to Order of Souls, and I'll tell you how to do that now. So the only real problem with Order of Souls is there's no quick way to do this. It's going to be your longest grind in the entire session, even with the help of Gilded Voyages. It's going to take a damn long time to get it all done. Sticking to the Devil's Roar and doing the Devil's Roar Order of Souls voyages while resetting the Emissary flag is a very, very great way to get this done. The reason I say do this in the Devil's Roar is because you can use the environment and the volcanoes to your advantage, taking down those skeletons with ease, sometimes even clearing waves before you make your way onto the island in certain situations. Of course, reaching level 15 will allow you to unlock that Emissary flag and grade that up to 5 every time you sell for bonus points, and then resetting for even more reputation after that. There's not a whole lot of method to this, it's just a lot of tedious grinding. So whether or not you do it off the start, towards the end, or in the middle of your grind session, it's going to be long no matter how you look at it. Having things like fire bombs and high tier food like pineapples and meat and fish could be very, very beneficial. The fire bombs tend to chew through the skeletons quite easily, and the high tier food is great for regen and keeping you alive in certain situations. For weapon loadout while doing this, it's not essential you follow what I did, but I found it easiest to use a sword and a blunderbuss. You'll find as long as you're close to the skeletons and aiming down the sights, you can pretty much clear them all in one shot from your blunderbuss, making this quite efficient. Using a sword as your backup is quite efficient, that way you can get maneuverability with the sword lunges and also the ability to swipe any skeletons that come your way. This was the longest and most tedious in our grind, taking a total of 3.5 hours to complete with the aid of stocking up gems and skulls from the previous merchant missions. Without the aid of a server over a line, so I'm going to expect this to take around 8 to 9 hours. It's long, it's slow, and it's very, very tedious. But trust me, once you get that done, you'll be on easy street. Of course, this is another time where you're going to want to save your level reputation purchase for level 49. That way you can buy your way to 50 and skip that whole final level altogether. This won't make a whole lot of difference. It'll probably shave around 30 or so minutes off of your grind, but it is very useful if you do have one ready to use for the month. And then finally, moving on to gold hoarders. You don't have to do this last. This is just the last one we did. So gold hoarders is predominantly a fast one to grind through, but it does take a bit of a slow approach to get there. Not only do you have to wait for level 15 until you can unlock the emissaries, you can't use the vaults until you hit level 25. And vaults are the main way to getting this completed. In the meantime, while you wait to level 25, I suggest you head on over to the Devil's Roar and keep doing the normal chest dig missions that you find around the Devil's Roar. There's no real method to that, just keep farming the missions and selling. Once you hit level 15, use the emissary to your advantage by raising to level 5 and selling at max level, and then resetting yet again. This whole process is going to take a couple of hours to get done, although once you do get to level 25, you're going to find it being quite easy from here on out. Upon reaching level 25, using the emissaries to your advantage, recycle and farm the vault voyage as much as you can. Don't farm the main world vaults though, stick to the Devil's Roar as it does have ashen loot that sells for a little bit more than normal loot. This does add up over time, trust me. It's also important to note you need to keep recycling missions. Don't stick on the base level 25 vaults for your entire grind, because you notice there's not going to be a lot of good stuff coming from them. The higher level in gold hoarders you are, the more beneficial and the more high tier loot you get from the vaults. With the actual key finding missions, you may not have to do all of the keys. You could find that the maps will reveal themselves with an X before you're even completed. Keep an eye on that, because you could shave some time off that way. It is also important to note that in the Devil's Roar, the only two vaults you can find are on Fetcher's Rest or Ashen Reaches, while the keys could be sanctioned anywhere around the Devil's Roar. If you have a crew of four, it could be beneficial to leaving two people on each island, that is Fetcher's Rest and Ashen Reaches. That'll be completely up to you though, I can't stand for or against it, it's just a useful idea that could be used into play. With the use of vaults and emissary flags, I'm going to expect this will take you around 4 hours to do normally. In my 7-hour Pirate Legend run, this took me around an hour and a half, but granted that was with the help of my server alliance also selling gold hoarders since they were on the same part of the voyages as me. But of course this will differ greatly assuming you don't have the Golden Glory Weekend to your advantage and a server alliance as well. Finally, making sure you sell all bits of loot once you reach grade 5 emissary is beneficial to this as well. Upon completing level 49, again, buy that final level and make your way to level 50. Once all of your three main factions have made level 50, you can unlock Pirate Legend and successfully complete this whole ordeal. As I mentioned at the start of this video, I'm only saying this to show you the tips I did, and I'm not promoting it to be done. I do feel like there is a question to be raised though, if this game is a little bit too easy now with all of the additions of aiding us, but I don't know. I'm not really a developer or someone to have a real opinion on that. I just want to bring up the question to you guys. Do you think that Pirate Legend is a bit too easy to maintain now, or do you think it's sitting perfectly fine? I don't want to see any hate towards other members of the community in the chat. Please keep it civil and nice. Let's just have a friendly debate and let's talk about it. With that being said, if this video has helped you in any way, feel free to leave a like to show your support, and if you want to see more content like this, I highly suggest you subscribe and hit that notification bell, as we do them every week. Again, thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video, and I'm going to speak to you all very soon. Check me out on Twitch if you want to see more events like this. You can find that down in the description below, and I'll see you all in my next video. Goodbye.